Hi everyone, this is Lanier Smith from Since Memory, and today we're going to be making a cocktail from this wonderful book, the Bergdorf Goodman cookbook. There you have it. And the cocktail is called a Paradise Lounge, which is a cocktail you can get in the restaurant at Bergdorf Goodman. So I will be mixing this up in my beautiful Spectre 007 cocktail shaker. I've got ice in it and we're ready to go. So let's get it going. So we need 1.5 ounces of the cane rum. And there you go. 1.5 ounces of cane rum. We need 1 ounce of the brandy. So here comes this beautiful bottle of brandy. That is 1 ounce of brandy. And then 1 ounce of the maple syrup. And you know, maple syrup isn't just for pancakes anymore. Here we go. This is gonna be so rich. There we go. And then 1 ounce of the lime juice. I'm gonna garnish this with a cherry or two. It doesn't call for a garnish, but I like to have a garnish in there. So here comes the lime juice. And we will shake this up. And here we go. I have a strainer to pour it with. And we will pour it into a beautiful martini glass. Here it comes. This is a distant relative of the sidecar, so it might have a similar taste. This is my very first one of these, by the way. Paradise Island is what this cocktail is called. One, two. So here we go. Stay tuned, and we are going to experience something brand new, an unboxing of something from France. Cheers. Oh boy, that's really good. So I've been looking through my Bergdorf Goodman cookbook because in a couple of weeks I'm having my very first dinner party here at Oakwood Abbey, and I'll be having friends over that I've met here in the area, some dear friends from one of my favorite places to go for coffee, and that is at the beautiful Anthem in Puyallup. So I'm going to be making a dinner from both this cookbook and from this wonderful cookbook that was given to me by my friend Hillary, which is the Audrey at Home cookbook. It is recipes of Audrey Hepburn's, and the book is by her son Luca Dotti. So we will be having some wonderful meals, or a wonderful meal made up from recipes from both of these books. So I'm looking forward to that. And who knows, perhaps I'll even do a little filming of the dinner party and you can be a part of it too. Let me know down below if you think that's a good idea. Anyway, cheers again. That is such a delicious, it's sweet, but not, you know, the maple syrup is not too sweet, and it certainly is cut by that great taste of the lime. It's just wonderful. So anyway, let's get on with this unboxing. And this particular fragrance is from an incredible house that I have had my eye on for a very long time. I first saw their fragrances in a very exclusive department store in San Francisco called Gumps. And I smell them, I love them, and I was so enchanted by the looks of the bottles and the packaging and this the whole history behind. So I did a little research and finally did pick one to begin exploring this house with. And this house is called Rancé 1795. It is actually based in Italy, but began in France in the 1600s. And it began in Grasse. And there they, as many perfume houses did in those days, they began by perfuming gloves, because the process of tanning leather left the gloves rather stinky. So perfume was used to perfume the gloves and make them wearable by people in the aristocracy. The house was founded by François Rancé, and in 1795, he turned away from perfuming gloves and just concentrated on perfume. And this of course is around the time of the French Revolution. And after the Revolution, when Napoleon came to power, he fell in love with François's wonderful fragrances. So François created a whole line of fragrances based on or inspired by Napoleon. And this particular fragrance, you can't talk about Napoleon without thinking of Triumph. And this is Triomphe Millesime. Millesime means vintage in French. And the thing is, this is a recreation, as are all the imperial line of this house, of fragrances made for Napoleon and Napoleon's family and for Josephine, etc. So these are recreations. The house has been ongoing ever since it began, but they have revived these fragrances. They also have newer fragrances too, but they've revived these classic fragrances. So let us explore this a little bit. What does it say here on the side of the box? This Millesime Rancé has been created exclusively using the rarest and most precious natural essences obtained in the best harvest, mixed and left to age in the purest artisan tradition of the Maison Rancé, established in 1795 by François Rancé. So there, and it says it in French on this side. And let's see what, yes, made in Italy. So I was right, the house is in Italy now, but it's still in the family. The current family is headed by Jean Sandro Rancé, Maurizio Crizia, and Giovanni Rancé. So let's get on with this and open it up and see what it's all about. So here we have the box. Open it up. And there is the bottle. It is absolutely gorgeous. Isn't that beautiful? And this is hand etched, as it was in the 1700s. Each bottle is hand etched of this particular fragrance. If you look very closely on the bottle and on the box, you can see the NB for Napoleon Bonaparte, the Imperial French Eagle. It is all just such a tribute to Napoleon and the Imperial French regime of France after the French Revolution. Just a glorious bottle, just beautiful. This fragrance was inspired by the fragrances, the smells of Napoleon's birthplace. And so François went to town to really fulfill that memory for Napoleon. So the head notes are bergamot, neroli, and mandarin. The mid notes are Bulgarian rose, magnolia, wisteria, and nutmeg. The base notes are patchouli, cistus labdanum, tolu balsam, and vanilla. And it is, the olfactory description would be fresh fougère and spicy, a fresh fougère that is spicy. So let's open it up and see what we think. There we go. Oh. Wow. This is just as I remember it from, I think I first smelled it in 2012. It is glorious. It is so magnificent, a beautiful masculine fragrance. It definitely has a real imperial punch to it. This blend of neroli, bergamot, and mandarin are very Mediterranean in the feel. And there is this smooth, very, very sensuous undercurrent of that magnolia. Magnolias are a kind of waxy flower, very big, very, very large blossoms. And then we have this wisteria hanging down in front into this fragrance. And a wonderful, wonderful blend of this Bulgarian rose with nutmeg sprinkled all over it. I can't wait for the dry down. So let's give this a little while to dry down and see what I think. I'll be right back. Hmm. You know, Napoleon, once on his way back from one of his campaigns, wrote to his wife Josephine and said, "Don't bathe. Just don't bathe. I'm coming home. Don't take a bath." You know, he kind of liked that little dirty, sensual thing going on with Josephine. And in the dry down, you get this beautiful, sensuous labdanum. And it reminds me of that quote because it's a little dirty, a little sexy, a little dangerous. I really love the dry down of this. You know, that olfactory description of fresh, that's just not there. It's fresh is a wrong word. I would say crisp, sharp, bright, and definitely spicy. The dry down is there is a touch of vanilla. You know how vanilla gives an oriental kind of, a lot of times a lot of people don't like vanilla because it can be overpowering and headachy, but here in this dry down, this labdanum, it's just wrapping me up and like in a big warm hug. I say that Triomphe by Rancé 1795 is a triumph indeed. It really is a beautiful fragrance. This house never ever gets any coverage on YouTube. I've never seen anything or heard many people talk about it, but it definitely needs to be promoted, explored, worn by people. It is truly, at least this fragrance, I haven't smelled the others, but I'm definitely going to be trying some more by this wonderful house. But this is a really special fragrance. So here we have this beautiful, beautiful Triomphe Millesime by Rancé 1795. This is Lanier Smith from Sense Memory saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say is your life. Cheers.